Hello, and a very warm welcome to LNT Royal YouTube channel.
Queen, Kate Middleton and William, wish Meghan Markle happy 39th birthday, with pic of them together. The Queen led royal well. Wishes to the Duchess of Sussex as she celebrates her 39th birthday in Los Angeles. The official royal family Instagram account this morning posted a photograph of the Queen and Meghan Markle at their first joint royal engagement alongside the warm message, wishing the Duchess of Sussex a very happy birthday. It was followed shortly afterwards by a post by Kate and William's Kensington Palace account, which shows a solo image of Meghan speaking to a young schoolgirl. The post read, "Wishing a very happy birthday to the Duchess of Sussex today." The messages are thought to be a show of support for Meghan amid the ongoing controversy surrounding the release of the Sussex's biography, Finding Freedom, which claims to lay bare a rift between the couple and the rest of the royal family. The Queen did not post on Meghan's birthday last year, suggesting specific effort has been made to present a united front amid claimed the biography has disclosed Her Majesty. Prince Harry and Meghan moved to the US with their son Archie just a few weeks before the coronavirus pandemic shut down the globe, and like everyone else have been living under lockdown. The family are living in a stunning mansion owned by filmmaker Tyler Perry. Birthday celebrations are likely to be low, key as the state of California, they now call home, reportedly has the highest number of COVID-19 cases in the US. From March 31st, Harry and Meghan stopped using their HRH styles and ceased to be senior working royals. In recent weeks, the focus of media attention has been on the release of Finding Freedom, the biography penned by Omid Scobie and Carolyn Durant. Scobie and Durant, they have spoken to more than 100 sources, including close friends of Harry and Meghan's, royal aides and palace staff, past and present, with all the information in the book having at least two sources. The Duke and Duchess deny giving any interviews or contributing to the book directly, but the intimate nature of some details raises questions over who the sources were. The biography has claimed Prince Harry and Meghan Markle hurt the Queen by unilaterally mapping out their future royal roles without her approval. There are also fears the book's publication could spark a fresh rift within the royal family. In other news, royal expert claims Prince Harry isn't as smart as Meghan Markle. Are Prince Harry and Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, intellectual equals? One royal expert claims that Harry is much less intelligent than his wife, although he has shown his intellect on many occasions. Find out why the royal author made this surprising claim. Royal expert finds Prince Harry is less intelligent than Meghan Markle. Author Lady Colin Campbell, who wrote the book Meghan and Harry, The Real Story, had some strong opinions about the Sussexes. According to Campbell, while the Sussexes have a very strong relationship and Prince Harry is besotted with Meghan, she also believes that Harry is desperate to please her. Campbell said, "In my opinion, Harry is a much less intelligent character than Meghan is, and I think he's so desperate to please her and go along with whatever she says, no matter how ill conceived it is. He is that besotted with her." Campbell added that Meghan is dominating in the relationship. "She wears the trousers and is as dominating, charming and captivating a personality as Princess Diana was in her marriage." Another expert thinks Prince Harry and Meghan Markle bring out the worst in each other. Campbell isn't the only expert who is critical of Prince Harry and Meghan's relationship. Angela Levin, author of Harry, Conversations with the Prince, has some concerns about how Meghan wanting to be a mega, what attention grabber with the eyes of the world on her, impacts Harry. In an article written for The Telegraph, Levin claims that Meghan is a fiercely ambitious woman who wants to be number one, and that quality in the Duchess changed Harry, who she believes went from charismatic and accessible to a nervy, tense man who seems constantly on edge. Evan further noted how she believes that, as a result, Prince Harry faded into Meghan's shadow. The biographer adds that the Sussexes bring out the worst in each other. Is Prince Harry's desire to make his wife happy damaging in some way? There is no shortage of criticisms when it comes to Prince Harry and Meghan. As Levin remarked in February, when Meghan and Harry prepared to exit the royal family, that she had some concern. Levin explained, "As he said before the wedding, What Meghan wants, Meghan gets. He's very, very keen on making her happy, I think to the detriment of Harry. Levin also thinks that Meghan wears the trousers in the marriage and, though she said Prince Harry was in search of a spiky woman when he was dating, someone with strength and opinions of their own, Levin called Meghan too spiky. She added, I don't think she finds it very easy to bend a bit and come to a compromise. Would Queen Elizabeth approve of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's Commonwealth message? Prince Harry and Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, recently had a talk with leaders from the Queen's Commonwealth Trust. There, the couple brought up the subject of colonialism and made statements about the Commonwealth's colonial past. The talk attracted some criticism from onlookers, but the other members of the royal family have not shared their thoughts on it. That has led some fans to wonder, how would Queen Elizabeth, the head of the Commonwealth, feel about Harry and Meghan's comments? What did Prince Harry and Meghan Markle say about the Commonwealth? Harry and Meghan's message centered on urging people to acknowledge the colonial past of the Commonwealth. Harry said, Certainly, when you look across the Commonwealth, there's no way that we can move forward unless we acknowledge the past. So many people have done such an incredible job of acknowledging the past and trying to right those wrongs, but I think we all acknowledge there is so much more still to do. Meanwhile, Meghan added, We have to, in this moment in time, say, We're going to have to be a little uncomfortable right now, because it's only in pushing through that discomfort that we get to the other side of this and find the place, as you're pointing out, where a high tide raises all ships. She then touched on the subject of racism in the Commonwealth, noting, It's not just in the big moments, it's in the quiet moments where racism and unconscious bias lies and hides and thrives. It makes it confusing for a lot of people to understand the role that they play in that, both passively and actively. Harry and Meghan's message attracted some criticism. While Harry and Meghan's message seems to have come from a place of good intentions, not everyone approved of it, that the Commonwealth, which is made up of 54 nations who joined voluntarily, is actually different from the British Empire. The outlet wrote, Many say the Commonwealth is a force for good, and has done much to progress beyond Britain's slave owner past. Royal photographer Arthur Edwards also told The Sun that Harry and Meghan's talk is an insult to Queen Elizabeth. Edwards said, To criticise the one thing the Queen cherishes above all things, which is preserving the Commonwealth, is an insult to her, no matter what the palace may say officially. Any country can look back and find faults, but we learn from history and move on. He also held Meghan responsible for filling Harry full of these ideas. Would Queen Elizabeth approve of Harry and Meghan's comments about the Commonwealth? Of course, the Queen herself has not spoken out about this event. However, contrary to what Edwards said, not everyone believes Her Majesty would be offended by Harry and Meghan. As reported by Express, politician Lord Harrell thinks Queen Elizabeth can see where Harry and Meghan were coming from. Lord Harrell said, I would think she fully understood the context. Harry has been very active and committed to Commonwealth activities. He's a real champion of the Commonwealth, and I think he was trying to explain to others outside government where we are going. I would have thought she understood it fully, frankly.
Please support growing LMT Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos are. Your support is the motivation for our to produce better videos. Stop. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.